call did not go through. Will you please try your call again?
In previous months, we have explored operas with extravagant settings, juggling complex plots and large casts of characters. But this month, we'll dial it back with a single-act opera of just one character. Prepare to hear La Voix Humaine. Thank you for joining us on Opera Avengers. I'm Alejandra Martinez, your guide to demystifying opera, an art form created by the people, for the people, and of the people. Today's podcast is brought to you by FreshBooks.com. Move your small business's accounting to the cloud with a free 30-day trial on www.gofreshbooks.com/opera. Additional support is brought by Audible.com. Get a free audiobook download and 30-day free trial at www.audibletrial.com/opera. Choose from over 180,000 titles to read on your iPhone, Android, Kindle, or MP3 player. As always, this podcast will include spoilers. In opera, there are so many nuances to absorb that knowing the story beforehand allows you to sit back and enjoy the performance without worrying about missing a subtitle or two. So think of our podcasts as your cheat sheet, and be free to enjoy every minute of high-flying opera. La Voix Humaine, or The Human Voice, is an operatic monologue about elle, a woman attempting to win back her lover over the phone while constantly interrupted by glitches and hang-ups. It's based on a play by Jean Cocteau, adapted into an opera in 1958, by composer Francis Poulenc. Poulenc, like many, was attracted to the material because he related to its personal story of a painful breakup and one-sided love. The curtain opens on a bedroom. Our main character, Elle, lies on the floor. She's staring at the ceiling. Finally, she is about to leave the room when the phone rings.
But the party you're attempting to reach has made another call before this call could be completed. Please try again.
Hello? Hello? No, ma'am, you hang up. No, this is not Dr. Schmidt. You have the wrong number. This is 08, not 07. Oh, this is ridiculous. Hello? Oh, it's you again. What do you want me to do? No. No. Ma'am, you hang up. Hello? Darling, is that you? Yes, I'm very well. Oh, God, it's like torture trying to get to you. Yes. Yes. No. You didn't try to call me 10 minutes ago, by chance, did you? I just stepped in. Oh, no, it's fine. Yesterday, I went out to dinner with Martha. Are you home? I was thinking... Yes, darling, last night? I went to bed right away. I had to take a sleeping pill, just one, at 9 o'clock. I had a small headache. I had lunch with Martha, we went shopping, and then I came back home. I have... What? Oh, yeah, I'm very strong. I have a lot of courage. Afterwards, Martha took me home. No, she is not. Anyway, you were right, as always. Well, I wore my pink dress... And my black hat, you know, the one that you got me? Yes, I'm still wearing my hat. And you stayed home, right? Hello? Oh, my darling, if you get cut off again, let me know. Hello? No, I'm here. It's a little difficult, I understand. Oh, the bag. Oh, darling, don't apologize. No, it's totally normal, and I'm stupid. I'm the one that's stupid. No, you're too kind. Yeah, I know. I didn't think I could be this strong either. Hello? Who's... No, not at all. I am calm. Can't you tell? I'm not hiding anything. No. I decided I was going to be strong, and I will... You know, I have what I deserve. Honey, listen. Hello? Darling? Hello, please let me talk. Please let me talk. Don't blame yourself. It's all my fault. Yes. Yes. Hey, do you remember the Sunday, that Sunday in Versailles? I'm the one who wanted to go. I'm the one who told you to shut up. I'm the one that told you that everything... That it was all the same to me, right? No. There you are wrong. I was the one who called you first. Tuesday. Yeah, I'm sure. Tuesday. Remember, it was the 27th. You know, I remember these days by heart. I don't know yet. Yes. Maybe. Oh, surely not right away. And you, tomorrow. I didn't know it was so soon. So, wait. It's easy. Listen, tomorrow, the bag will be with the concierge. Me? You know, I might stay. Or maybe I'll go. A few days in the countryside? At Martha's? Yes, darling. Yes. Hello? Yes, I'm speaking very loudly. Do you hear me? I said, can you hear me? Funny, because I hear you as clearly as if you're here in the room with me. Hello? Hello? No, I can't hear you anymore. Oh, great. No, you can hear me. That's fine. I can hear you better than anything else. But your phone is echoing. It doesn't sound like your phone. Well, you know, you better watch out, because I can see you now, you know. Which scarf are you wearing? Well, your red scarf, of course. You have your sleeves pushed up to your elbows. In your left hand, the receiver. In the right, a pen. You're scribbling something, I bet. Faces, hearts, stars. Oh, it's so good to hear you laugh. You know, I have eyes instead of ears. No, hon, I won't be afraid. Yes, I promise you. I don't know. I don't like to look at myself. Yesterday, I found myself face to face with an old lady. No. In the mirror. An old lady with white hair and a host of small wrinkles. Oh, darling, it's nice of you to say that, but, you know, an admirable figure, well, that's... I like it better when you call me little monster. Yeah. Oh, yes, I was joking. You're stupid. Luckily, you love me. If you didn't love me, and you were cruel and clever, You know, you could make this phone into a terrible weapon. Me? Wicked?
The number you have
Hello?
Reached? 862.
Hello?
4,
darling?
594.
Can you hear me?
For trouble. Please try your call again later.
Hello? Hello?
862-4594 is being checked for trouble. Please try your call again later.
Hello? Is that you? Oh, operator. Oh, listen, I was cut off. I don't know. Oh, you were able to get through? Hello? Is that you? Oh, Joseph. Yeah, I was cut off. I don't know. He's not there with you? Right. Of course. He won't be back until later. I'm stupid. He must have called me from the restaurant. That's it. We got cut off. Okay. Thank you. Good night, Joseph.
We're sorry. Your call did not go through. Will you please try your call again?
Do you need to send invoices? Chart your expenses? You can save it all to the cloud with FreshBooks. To try FreshBooks free for 30 days, just go to www.gofreshbooks.com/opera. Are you a bookworm? Audible.com is offering a free audiobook download in addition to a free 30-day trial to test out their library of 180,000 books, including Divergent by Veronica Roth. To download your free audiobook, go to www.audibletrial.com/opera. Again, that's audibletrial.com/opera for your free audiobook. No, I was waiting. It was ringing, and I was trying, and then there was nobody. Of course. Are you tired? You know, it means so much to me that you called. No, I'm here. What? Forgiven? No, that's absurd. Nothing. It's nothing. Nothing at all. You're wrong. Listen, I have never lied to you. Yes, I know. I believe you. No, darling, that's not it. No, it's just that, well, I just lied to you. Right now, on the phone, just 15 minutes ago, I lied to you. I don't like lying to you, even if it's for your own good. Nothing serious. I only lied about what I wore. I also lied about going out to dinner with Martha. I didn't wear my pink dress or my hat. I'm wearing a coat. You know, I just have to tell you, while I was waiting for your call, I was sitting, I was standing, I was pacing, just going crazy. So I put on a coat and I was going to take a taxi and I was going to wait outside your window. Wait, I know, it sounds crazy. I don't know. No, you're right. I tell the truth. I swear. Okay, the truth. I didn't eat anything. I couldn't. I was sick. Last night, I couldn't sleep. So I told myself if I took more sleeping pills, I would sleep better. And if I took all the sleeping pills, I could sleep without dreaming, without waking. I swallowed 12 in warm water and I had a dream. I no longer felt light or cold, and my heart started to slow. But God, after an hour, I called Martha. Yes, I didn't have as much courage as I thought. Oh, honey. It was 4 in the morning. She arrived with a doctor. He wrote a prescription, and Martha stayed with me up until this evening. I begged her to leave, because you said that you were going to call. And I was afraid that if you did, she wouldn't let me speak to you. All right. Don't worry. Hello? Oh, you're so good to me, darling. My poor darling. Who I've treated so badly. Yes. Please, say anything. Just hearing your voice makes me feel good, darling. Sometimes, when we were together, I like to rest my head against your chest. You know, times like those, I heard your voice just exactly the same as I hear it tonight over the phone. Hello? I hear music. I said I hear music. Where are you? Well, you should pound on the wall and tell your neighbors to turn off their stereo. God. Anyway, Martha's doctor will return tomorrow. Don't worry. Yes. She'll keep you updated. What? Oh, no, darling. I feel much better. If you hadn't called me right now, I don't... Forgive me. I know this whole thing has just been intolerable, but you must understand me. I'm suffering. And this phone, it's now the only thing that connects us. The day before yesterday, I slept. I went to bed with the phone next to me. Yes, I know, I'm ridiculous, but I slept with the phone in my bed, and despite everything, you and I are connected through this phone. For 5 years. Yes, I know. But darling, 5 years. I spent my time waiting for you, worried that if you were just the slightest bit late, that maybe something happened to you, and thinking that I would just die if something happened to you, and feeling so much better when I saw you. I feared losing you. And now that I'm talking to you, the only reason I can talk to you is because you're talking to me. I can breathe now, because at least I hear your voice. Yes, yes, my love, I slept. But darling, I have nothing to pass the time without you. At least Martha has her life organized all by herself. What? Oh, it's been 2 days. He's avoided me. I wanted to call him, to pet him, but he doesn't want to come out of his room. Do you know the other day, he actually bit me? I swear he's frightening me. He doesn't eat. He doesn't move. You know, this is crazy, but maybe he thinks I hurt you. Poor animal. I can't blame him. He loves you. He doesn't see you anymore, and he must blame me. But honey, how could I know? I'm no longer myself. Hello? Hello? Excuse me. Excuse me. Get out. You shouldn't be listening into this call. You know, we don't just talk to entertain you. Just hang up. Hang up right now. Finally. Oh, no. Finally, darling, she hung up. Yeah, I heard what she was saying, but you know, she doesn't know you. She thinks that you're just like every other guy out there, but she's wrong. You know, for some people, a breakup is just, you know, you hate each other and you go your separate ways, but we're better than that. And it's better just to take a step back and to laugh at them if they make fun of us, you know? Nothing. Nothing. It's just, it's like we were talking like we used to. And suddenly, the truth of it all just returns to me. You know, when you see someone you love, you can lose your head. You can forget your promises, and just a single look can change everything. A single embrace. But over the phone, what's done is done. Hey, calm down. You know, who tries to kill themselves twice? I don't know how to buy a gun. Could you see me buying a gun? No, I should have been brave. I'm sorry, I know. Sometimes lies are useful. If you had lied because you wanted to make our breakup less painful. No! No, I'm not saying you're lying. I'm saying that if you were lying and I knew it, I'm not explaining this very well. For instance, if you're not actually home, but somewhere else, with another woman, perhaps? No, darling, I believe you. I believe that you're home. Please, don't take that tone with me. I was just saying that if you had lied to me, and I knew that you were doing it just to spare my feelings, I would feel nothing but more love for you.
Hello? Distance company circuits are busy now.
Hello?
Will you please try your call again later?
God. Please. Please, please let him call me back. Please let him call me back. Please, God. I'm I'm sorry. We were cut off again. I was telling you that if you had lied to protect me, and I knew about it, that, well, I don't think that I could love you any more than I do already. Of course. Of course, my love, I know it must be horrible. I've never had the courage. Yeah, I had a dream. We were so close, but really? We have a whole city between us. I have the cord wrapped around my neck. I have your voice wrapped around my neck. Oh. Honey, how could you imagine that I would think such a terrible thing? I know that this is a million times worse for you than it is for me. No, no, no. Listen, dear, listen. So you said you're going to be in Marseille the night after next. Please. It would mean a lot to me if you didn't stay at our usual hotel. You're not angry? No. I'm only imagining things out loud. You understand? I don't know if I do. Thank you. Thank you. You're so good to me. I love you. So, this is it. I'm going to bed. I was going to say it once, but... Oh, that's better. Much better. Honey. My darling. I'm strong. I'm strong. I'm lying in bed with your voice wrapped tight around me. I love you. I love you. I love you.
Reached a number that has been disconnected or is no longer in service. If you feel you have reached this recording an error, please check the number and try your call again.
Sorry about that. It's not 100% clear what interrupted our broadcast. I certainly hope that lady's okay. So, La Voix Humaine is a revolutionary opera because in an intimate setting, it asks so much of the audience to piece a story together based on half of a conversation, while delving deep into the desperate emotions after a messy breakup. Until next month, I'm Alejandro Martinez. Thank you for listening. Opera Avengers is a production of the Great Lakes Light Opera, an organization based out of Cleveland, Ohio, dedicated to bringing opera and all local musical arts to everyone. Want to learn more? Visit us at greatlakeslightopera.com. Want to help out? Check our donation page or email us at megan@greatlakeslightopera.com. Oh, and let us know what you'd like to hear next.